All right, with this West 2 Facebook Live update, just wanted to give a quick update here from the 2 o'clock intermediate advisory. Doesn't affect the cone, but it certainly does give us a better idea as to what's going on out there in the tropics. Again, a very active, very busy out there. We've got post-tropical Fiona doing a lot of destruction southeast Canada. Gaston, again, over to the south and west of Lisbon. And then Hermine is going to kind of hug the coast there of West Africa. Another little wave there in between the Lesser Antilles and Africa, not going to do much. And then all eyes, of course, are going to be on Ian here as it continues to develop. I wanted to get a little bit of a close-up shot here for you and kind of give you the latest look on it, and you can see what's going on right there. It's starting to get that look, that turning and twisting, trying to get those storms there around the entire core, not just one side, which is what we were seeing earlier this morning. Water vapor channel here. Yesterday we had, of course, a lot of wind shear. Not seeing as much of that today as we did yesterday. So you still have that little high to the north right in there. There's a little bit of a low. It's kind of like right in here. And one of the things that we're going to have to watch is this. How soon does this begin to turn, Ian, more towards the west-northwest and then the northwest as it moves off, generally speaking, to the west? So that's, again, one of the things that we're going to be watching. Remember, that northwestern Caribbean, folks, it is jacked. This is some high-octane, deep, warm water in the northwestern Caribbean. So the farther west that this goes, closer to Cancun on the western tip there of Havana, that would mean more added additional potential for this storm to try and develop. There's Ian. This is the 2 o'clock advisory. Now moving west. Okay, moving west at 16. Winds are at 45 miles an hour. Pressure is starting to come down as we go through and have gone through the last 24 hours. Let me show you the tip of the cone there. Big differences here, so to speak, in the advancement more towards the north. All of central Florida is now in the cone. Believe it or not, Miami-Dade is not, because of that trend more towards the west here, bringing that track there just north of Tampa, approaching Hernando County and potentially Marion County, while potentially shooting up towards Jacksonville. So again, you take a look at the storm tracks. We get new models coming in here within the next hour, but the trend this morning has been more towards the west. Look at that, between Cancun and Havana. Look, laser locked in. That's what's going on right there. Then we start to see that bend from the Big Bend, that's the H Wharf, over towards the I-4 corridor. Let me see if I can, let's see here. Let me show it to you this way. So this is gonna be, let's see here, models. Don't want to do that. Yeah, let's do the animation. I want to show you, give me the animation. Just bear with me right there. There's a look at the animation, and notice there's our storm. Incredibly good agreement now, west of Havana, potentially staying in the core of the warmest waters right there. Then by Wednesday, you can start to see that turn. Tampa, west of Tampa, I-4 is the right side of the envelope of the models, and then a good chunk of them very close to Marion County and over towards the Big Bend there of the Panhandle. So again, a lot to watch here, again, a little bit of a push back towards the west. Now, one of the things I love to do is show you the cone, but then superimpose all of the models. Very good agreement. Initially, there one model there on the outside of the left side of it, but notice how, for the most part, the majority of the models are on that center point and then off to the north and west. Center point off towards the north and the west. We'll get some new model runs here between 2:30 and 3:30 and have those on air for you tonight at 5 and 6. So that's the trend, that's the tendency. We're still in that front right quadrant, but the point I've got to make here for everybody is that, you know, the farther west the center of the storm goes, the core of the strongest winds go farther to the west. And that's what we're hoping for as it becomes really game time by Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday of next week. Models here all indicating a major hurricane by as early as Monday night. And then as we go through Tuesday and Wednesday, you can see Cat 3 and Cat 4, potential storm there, either going up the western side of the Florida Peninsula or coming ashore. So a lot of people have been asking me about Charlie and Francis. Charlie's that blue line, and there's the cone now, the Ian forecast, again, just to the west of that. So very similar, and we're watching this cold front to the north of it as we go through the next couple of days. The longer the time it takes for this storm to make that turn to the north, the farther west I believe it'll go as it comes into the Gulf of Mexico. GFS, pretty far to the west. The European now, which was over South Florida 2 runs ago, is coming ashore very close to the Tampa Bay area. And you can see the GFS there. Oops, didn't mean to do that. The GFS, right there, the GFS slowing down west of Tampa. And look at the Euro coming in south of Tampa. So that has been the trend, folks, as we've gone through the last couple of model runs. And that's what we're going to continue to watch. So I'm going to wrap this up with this particular graphic. The timing of Ian, the first arriving tropical storm force winds. Tuesday evening, South Florida. Wednesday morning, Central Florida. And then Wednesday evening up to the north. If it continues to slow down, we adjust those values back. If it looks like it's going to speed up, then we'll make it Tuesday morning and yada, yada, yada. One final note. The rainfall forecast on many of the models is predicting anywhere from a half a foot to potentially a foot of rain across Central Florida. So we need to make sure that you folks are paying close attention to all of the different components and aspects. I do want to show this particular graphic here real quick. So this is the wave action. This is the wave action based on a Cat 3, Cat 4 potential hurricane. You can see the red, orange. Look at that. 40 to 45 foot wave action. Right there. You talk about the potential for storm surge. It's incredible. That's one of the things, folks, that we're going to have to watch as we sit and babysit this thing. And the timeline, one more time, I'm going to end it on this. So today, you know, the trend has been more towards the west. That's good. We still want you to get those hurricane kits taken care of this weekend. Monday, you're putting up some ply locks, if you have that, storm shutters. You're thinking about shutting them for Tuesday. And then Wednesday, we think the storm is going to arrive. So the confidence today, there's still a good divergence at the end, so it's still low. We think that that's going to improve, though, by Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday. All right, game, got to answer the phone. Boss is calling. I'll have an update on Facebook Live again tonight at 8.